Welcome to the Altium Designer in Essentials course, Getting Started module. There are a few ways to start Altium Designer once it's installed. Normally I start it from the PCB start menu, either clicking on it or if I need to, navigate to it under the Altium folder. Alternately, clicking on the desktop icon if it's available or double-clicking on an Altium project file will open the tool. Now that we have the tool open, we will need to license the tool running on our machine, and then we can set up the preferences for the tool. Starting with licensing, if this version is not already licensed, you'll be prompted to license it. We will need to sign in before we can retrieve a license. So let's sign in. Entering your Altium Live username and password will allow you access to your licenses from Altium. Moving to the Updates tab, we can install updates if desired following the same approach as with the purchased install. Click to download and then when asked to restart, click Yes. Allow the update when asked to your machine and the download and update will run, ending with the tool restarting. To check on the currently installed versions of Altium Designer and for any updates, system extensions, or software extensions, click on the circle arrows. This refreshes the window, checking for updates, providing you are signed into Altium and have internet access. Clicking on the gear in this window, we can check our preferences for how often we look for updates and whether it is a global or local installation. Now that the tool is licensed and the extensions configured, we can move on to customizing the tool preferences. Here we can set up the Altium Designer options under the listed categories. One thing to note, these preferences are stored locally on this particular PC platform. Starting with System and then General, we can enable the startup options for Altium Designer. If you're working on one design at a time, checking the Reopen Last Workspace can be a time saver. One instance where it makes sense to leave that unchecked would be if you are in a consulting role working on many different designs. In that case, you would open up Altium Designer and then pick the particular project to work on. The Localization section by default comes with the used localized resources unchecked. Checking this allows the user to enable local installed languages to be used for the software. A reset or restart of the tools is required if this is selected. Selecting View icon, you see a few options for the speed of the pop-up panels, and some general information about how things are grouped or presented from within Altium. Looking at the Documents bar section located in the lower right of the window, you can determine how and whether or not you want to group documents in the project panel. Notice I typically would check by document kind. Grouping also based on projects is another option that can prove handy if you're working on multiple projects simultaneously. Clicking on the account management icon, we see the option to auto connect to Altium as well as the auto sign in for Altium Live. Continuing to look at the system preferences for transparency, here you'll note that both the transparent floating windows and dynamic transparency are checked. Enabling these two options is recommended to hide pop-up toolbars if they would block the current operation. The best example of this is when you place a component out of the library on the schematic sheet. The library panel hides to allow for the placement of the component on the schematic. Continuing under the system folder, let's look at the navigation options. I typically use the settings you see. You can modify them if it suits your needs. Looking at Design Insight, we have a number of options that give you pop-ups or additional information. We will discuss the effects of these later. Note the current boxes checked are a good starting point. Looking at the Projects panel, we can see there are a number of options that affect how files in the Projects panel are displayed. Under General, the Show VCS status has been checked. This allows for the tool to provide visual feedback if you have modified a file that is under SVN control. Again, document grouping allows you to group by document type, and the single click allows you to open up documents by single clicking on them from the Projects panel. Looking at the default locations option, we can see where the tool's default document path is, library path, and output job paths are located. You can change this if needed. There's a simple way to restore the look and feel of Windows for Altium by using the pull-down menus at the bottom of the Preferences window. Clicking on Set to Defaults and then Default All performs a full reset. Note you could save your preferences to a file and use the save file on another machine to load your settings or to restore the settings you have here. Under the mouse wheel configuration, the configuration of the mouse button assignments can be modified if needed. As you can see, there are a number of major categories for Altium preferences. We will be looking at some of these in future modules. This concludes our initial tool setup and licensing.